good?
Yep, we're good.
I'm streaming!
What?
I'm streaming the shit.
Oh my god!
Right? Hey!
Who's watching?
I told everybody. So, whoever watching is watching. I know Sam's watching. Nick should be watching. A few others.
What charge do you have?
$44.
Just a little bit. Thank you so much.
Hopefully they don't say anything. If they do, it's not.
Huh?
I said,
Everyone, please rise and remove your hats for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the singing of National Anthem.
This is hard.
Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to Republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
Hi, Phillips.
I'm sorry. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Oh my God!
Yeah,
we can sit down now.
Oh, thank God.
And welcome graduates, family, and friends to the sixth
Anna,
graduation
have to do the same
ceremony
for me.
At Citrus Valley High School.
I mean, you want to hold
it is second? My pleasure to introduce our counselors, Lupe Barba, Linda Garcia, Trish Scott, Tony Wood, and Diana Farley, and school board members.
Can I move
President
this chat?
Donna West, Vice President Patty Hollihan, Clerk of the Board Jim O'Neill,
so we only see it.
Member Christina Paracci, and member Alex Farah.
I
would also like to introduce Executive Cabinet members, Superintendent Lori Rhodes, Assistant Superintendent Bernie Kavanaugh. And Assistant Superintendent Sabine Robertson Phillips. Let's give it up for her too. And joining us on the stage this evening is a San Bernardino County board member, Hardy Brown. Lori Rhodes has been our superintendent for nearly 10 years. She is retiring in a few days, and Citrus Valley High School would like to thank her for her service and immense dedication to the students and our entire school district. We would like to honor her by giving her lifetime entrance to all of our events.
Can't you go
to the landscape?
I don't think so.
What does that do? We hope that you can come watching the black. Blackhawks for many
years.
Tonight, we have a very special ceremony planned for this wonderful graduating class. Our ceremony began with banners carried in and placed on the stage. They represent the cornerstone of Citrus Valley High School. CLASS stands for Character, Leadership, Attitude, Scholarship, and Service. Staff members nominated senior students who best personify each of the characteristics of CLASS. And they also nominated students they believed best embodied all of the attributes of CLASS to carry the CLASS of 2017 banner. This is not an easy process because all of our students exhibit CLASS each and every day. However, these six students deserve to be recognized for being selected to represent their entire class and lead the processional. Selected as the senior who embodies the tenet of character is Heaven Rivera, who always does the honor of carrying the leadership banner was given to Lauren Loeb, who has been an outstanding leader for 4 years. The student who was selected to carry the attitude banner is Blake Westerberg, who exudes a positive attitude. The scholarship banner is carried by Emily Fu, who has never received anything lower than an A in grades 6 through 12. Sheridan Selby was selected to represent the area of service because of her 4 years of outstanding service to outstanding organizations and to Citrus Valley High School. Representing the class of 2017 and selected as the senior who best embodies all of the tenets of CLASS, carrying in the class of 2017 banner and leading the graduates into the bowl tonight is Mark Rossi, who excels. It is now my pleasure to introduce our ASB president, Lauren Loeb, and ASB vice president, Aaron Holder.
Landscape.
Yeah, this is landscape.
Does that naturally switch?
Yeah, no. Hello everyone. Tonight we will be reading a poem called Nothing to Fear. There is nothing to fear, you're as good as the best, as strong as the mightiest too. You can win in every battle or test, for there's no one just like you.
There's only one you in the world today, so nobody else you see. Can do your work in as fine a way, you're the only one there'll be.
So face the world and live it yours, to conquer and love and live, and you'll find the happiness that endures in just the measure you give.
There's nothing too good for you to possess, nor heights where you cannot go. Your power is more than belief or guess, it is something you have to know.
There is nothing to fear, you can and you will, for you are the invincible you. Set your foot on the highest hill, there's nothing you cannot do.
I would now like to introduce Lena Nguyen.
Do I really? I'm sorry.
Hi. Like a mama bird, Citrus Valley High School is finally ready to eject us away from our safe and comfortable nest that we called high school. I remember our very first day stepping in as freshmen at Citrus Valley High School. We were significantly shorter, prepubescent, and full of teen angst, getting lost aimlessly in those e-building hallways.
Yep.
It's easy to see high school as just another hurdle, something to simply get over with to move on to bigger and better things. We're so focused on looking forward to where we're gonna go that we often lose sight of exactly where we are in the moment. We're so caught up complaining about tests and teachers and homeworks that we forget what an incredible opportunity and privilege it is to have such amazing education as the one provided by Citrus Valley High School. Now, it's all about what we've learned from our experiences. This is the place where we learned exactly what footprints we want to leave on the world. It's where we discovered what we love to do and can envision ourselves going into student debt for. It's where we learned about discovering ourselves, the good, the bad, and the ugly. It's about discovering our values, our beliefs, where we're willing to learn and what we're willing to fight for. It's also about the people. You see, Citrus Valley High School has taught us so much more than the main academics. It's taught us about class, a mantra that we can pretty much recite in our sleep now. It's followed us in the hallways, it's followed us in the classrooms, it's pretty much also in bathrooms as well if you look on the posters. It's everywhere. And it's taught us about community. It's taught us that out there in the real world, it takes a lot more than just brains to make it. It takes class. It takes character, leadership, the right attitude, and service to others. This has taught us how to lead our life with integrity. It's about knowing your success, but owning up to your mistakes. It's about being the best and most successful person you can be. But these lessons are nothing without the amazing faculty and teachers that have brought us here. You see, these are people that have invested their entire lives to seeing us grow into the leaders they know we can be, and I know our success is nothing without them. I'd also like to thank the parents, each and every one of them out here today, waiting hours in the sun just for their kids. They've sacrificed so much to ensure that we have the best future out there for us. Now, it's really surreal to see us all here, where we thought we would be impossibly behind years ago. That's not to say that this journey was easy by any means. At times, getting to graduation felt like a climb. Not in the poetic Miley Cyrus sense, but in the sense that high school was really hard. And sometimes, I know we're standing here left with regrets, either academic or personal, or maybe it just moved too fast for us. And we wish that we can turn back the time and just do it over again. But the beauty of life is that we must move on. And that the future is a blank slate for us to do whatever we want with it. For the last year, no matter where we go, no matter who we talk to, we're met with one terrifying question. What are you gonna do with your life? But now the answer is anything. I'm sitting here with people who are going to save lives, transform technology, represent our country, defend it, and represent our people. And thankfully, moving forward means that we can do anything that we want with whatever opportunities are provided for us. There's a quote that comes to mind when I think about all that we have waiting for us by F. Scott Fitzgerald. It goes, "For what it's worth, it's never too late, or in my case, too early, to be exactly who you want to be. There are no rules to this thing. You can start now. You can change or stay the same. But for what it's worth, I hope you lead a life that you're proud of. And if not, I hope you have the courage to start over again. Class of 2017, we've been through a lot together this year, from a failed senior prank to a lot of sleepless nights, the AP test mental breakdowns, and this ridiculous plague called senioritis, well, we finally made it. Although high school may be over, I hope that for each and every one of us, learning and growth never stops. Learning not in the, when am I ever gonna use the Pythagorean theorem way, but in the sense that we'll learn from the failures we'll face, from the people we'll meet, and from the world and experiences all around us. As we've heard Ms. Bruce say every single morning for the past 2 years of our lives, we are the authors of our own life story. We hold the power to reinvent this story at any time we'd like, to write ourselves a new and better future.
Anna, don't cry.
And we hold that power today. So, class of 2017, let's make it a good one and do it with class.
The water balloons?
Oh, yeah. That was the water balloons.
They made it the Linker room.
Oh, yeah.
They checked took everybody's out, trunks, too.
Yeah. They took all the water balloons.
There were, like, more than 600 balloons.
Yeah, so we
checked. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah. Why? I don't understand why they turned.
There's the red balloons.
It's so stupid.
They said it was the red one.
Makes sense, though. Shaky hands shit. Remember the saying? Now it's
really. That's not celebratory.
That's not even a thing. What song is this?
Hold on to me as we go. As we roll down this unfamiliar road.
Oh, you want me to hold the papers? I'll hold the papers.
And all these ways.
Great men and women have walked across this stage. Great scholars, great athletes, great future scientists, doctors, and engineers, great future educators and entrepreneurs, great people have walked across this stage. Now it's our turn. I stand before you at your high school graduation as each of us prepares to take the steps across this stage and take the next steps in life. For these steps, and indeed each step you take hereafter, I encourage you to do it with class. But what is class? I could read off to you each of the oft-quoted definitions of class, that character is doing the right thing, that leadership is being a role model, that attitude is being positive, that scholarship is doing your best in academics, and that service is taking time to give back to your community. But that's what you're expecting. Instead, I offer up these definitions of class. I claim that character is the steadfastness to do what you believe is right and adhering to it, whether others are watching or not. That leadership is having the strength to make the decisions that others cannot, and in doing so, inspiring others to become leaders themselves. that attitudes is being able to gauge your surroundings to determine which reaction will be most effective in bettering each situation. That scholarship is having an insatiable craving to learn about every topic that interests you and pursuing knowledge tirelessly. That service is always aiming to better yourself and your community at all times, through any means possible. These admirable qualities are how each of us will stand out as we transition from high school to adulthood, because they defy expectations. Allow me to repeat that. Defy expectations. Now, I know that seems an unorthodox statement to hear at a graduation, especially because many of us have spent our entire lives doing our best to meet the requirements placed on us by our teachers, our coaches, and our parents. However, defying expectations is not always a bad thing. In fact, our society would not be the same without it. Rosa Parks was expected to give up her seat on the bus, but she defied expectations and took a seat to take a stand, thus becoming an outstanding icon of the civil rights movement. Marie Curie, as a woman in early 20th century France, was expected to manage her husband's household, but she instead defied expectations by going to university and graduating first in her class, thereafter earning 2 Nobel Prizes. Bill Gates was going to major in mathematics at Harvard, but he defied expectations when he dropped out and, through patience, persistence, and innovation, built a multi-billion dollar corporation and helped usher in our current age of technology. Defying expectations is how we make progress as a society. It's how individuals are able to stand out and make a difference. And it's what I challenge you to do. Of course, not everyone will be able to found a corporation or cure a disease, but you can still make a difference by defying expectations in your own way. If that means not quite living up to your parents' hopes for you, so be it. If that means choosing an entirely different career path than what your parents have set for you, then so be it. If that means going above and beyond the requirements placed on you by your teachers, your school, society itself, so be it. And even if that only means stepping out of your comfort zone and surprising yourself, so be it. Look around you. You're surrounded by your peers, the graduating class of 2017, some of whom you've spent years with, and others whom you swear you've never seen before today.
Honestly.
Either way, we'll hopefully all see each other again, perhaps at our high school reunion, or on the news, or just passing by on the street. However we meet again, it is my hope that each one of us will be able to surprise everyone else with how far we will have come and how much we will have accomplished. My fellow Blackhawks, we are the graduating class of 2017. We are the last class composed entirely of 90s babies. So while we may be the only ones who will remember the 90s, let us ensure that everyone will remember us. Exemplify the tenets of class with which we are all so familiar. Find success in your endeavors, whatever they may be. Seize each day for all it's worth. Soar high with Blackhawk pride. And in all you do, defy expectations. This is the first day of the rest of your life. So make it a good life or not, that choice is yours. And I hope all of you choose to make your lives great. Thank you. I want to introduce Citrus Valley High School Choir.
Can you sit on the other side?
Yeah, I can sit on the other side.
Can you sit on this thing?
No. She's hidden quiet. Yeah, we're supposed to. I'm pretty sure we're supposed to go in line. No, it'd be easier, but they choose not to. I was born in 1999 and I remember the 90s. Hidden? It's on a, he's not in the group, he's a part of a different stream. He even streams on his own.
These people.
I know.
Live stream.
just an ad.
Show them.
Yeah, can I say hi?
Show
them. We the people, by the people. By the people.
Oh, shit. I mean, fix my tassel. I know, that's what I said. You do anything.
Right,
you know,
babe. Oh, look.
Fucking air, like. There
was such an overwhelming amount of people that were signed up for this class that we were warned multiple times about how much work we had to put into AP classes. Yep. And we even had an assembly that we all got called up to just so we knew what was in store for us. But that didn't stop us, and we didn't back down. So, because there are so many people signed up, this guy, this brave soul, had to step up, and he had to have 6 periods instead of 5.
Oh,
that's AP Gov and Econ on a constant loop for 5 days a week straight for the past 32 weeks. Luckily, I think it's safe to say he made his class very enjoyable and even threw in a few life lessons that made us a lot better people and more mature. I think the one that I will always hold on to is to never go out on Halloween night and get chased by police sirens and not stop. So right now, let's welcome on the stage a man with so much wisdom, Mr. Carpenter.
Woo!
heard six. We have six.
You gotta stand up.
Oh, we gotta stand up? Shit. Oh, well. Fuck it.
Vice President. Thank you for that amazing introduction, Leah. I appreciate it. I don't ever remember telling that story. I'd like to start tonight by saying thank you to everybody that's here tonight. I would like to thank our members of the Redlands Unified School District Board for taking time to be here. I would like to thank Lori Rhodes for being here tonight, and I'd like to thank everyone at the district who makes this night possible. I would like to thank all of the teachers, all of our amazing teachers, for being here tonight and for everything that they do to make our school amazing and to make our school special. I would like to thank Ms. Bruce, all of our assistant principals and all of our staff for all the amazing work that they do. I'd like to thank parents and family for taking the time to be here on this amazing, amazing night. And most importantly, I would like to thank you, class of 2017, for everything you have done over the last 4 years to make this night so amazing. I would also like to thank you for giving me this opportunity, for giving me what will likely be the pinnacle of my career. If you're willing, I would like to take all of you guys back. I want to take you back to a very special day that all of you will likely remember. That day was the very first day of high school. If you can remember that day, okay? Some of you were lucky enough to have new clothes, maybe new shoes. Some of you, unlike me, your hair was perfect. You had maybe a new backpack. Remember, you had the binder with the dividers?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Perfectly labeled. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
A little piece of blank sheet of paper in each one.
Yeah. Yep.
Two pens and a pencil. You got it. You walked through the gates and you looked for your friends and you hoped that they still remembered you after that long summer between 8th and 9th grade. You sat down in your first period and your teacher introduced you to class and the tenets of class and started talking to you about the importance of graduation. But you have to agree with me, in 9th grade, graduation seems so far away. Yeah. Graduation seems so far away. You probably didn't even pay attention to us when we talked to you about the importance of graduation.
Yeah.
Now, what an amazing night it is. What an amazing night it is to sit here and realize that it is graduation night for you guys. That event 4 years ago seemed so far away has now become a reality. Class of 2017, I want you to realize that tonight is graduation, and tonight is your last night as high school students.
My God! No! I don't want to think about it.
When you wake up in the morning, you will have this strange feeling will come over you, and this feeling will be that you're supposed to be somewhere, because you are supposed to be somewhere. It's just you don't have to be there. While everyone else at Citrus Valley High School is finishing their finals, you are done. Congratulations. I remember that morning, right? It was a long, long time ago, but I remember that morning. And what I remember most about that morning is I remember a feeling of excitement, but at the same time, I remember a feeling of fear. And I think it was the fear more than anything that overwhelmed me. What I feared most was, what am I going to do with my future? What path am I going to put myself on? And how do I know what path I'm supposed to be? Okay. After high school, it seemed important to get a job. Seemed important to start taking classes at the community college, right? I started along a path that started with criminal justice. Then I moved on to English. Had a bit of a sidetrack in art for a while. Thought maybe business was the right idea for me. And then I settled into history and realized, why not? The point I'm trying to make, I guess, is I didn't know what path I was trying to go down, but I knew there was a path for me, right? It doesn't matter whether you know you're going in the right direction or if you know exactly what path you're supposed to be on. What matters is that you're pursuing a path and that you're pursuing your own path. Okay? Find a path that is best for you, right? Find a path that you feel is best for you and pursue it. Okay? My path took me to a place, to be honest, that I never thought I would come back to. I never thought I would be back here. But once I got here, what I realized is my path took me to a place with amazing teachers. It took me to a place with amazing friends. And it took me to a place where I get to work with amazing students. Amazing students. You don't always know where your paths are supposed to go. You don't always know where your paths are going to take you. But in any event, every now and then you pursue a path that you never thought was right for you and you realize it's where you were always supposed to be. Okay? I wish I could keep this speech going all night. This honor going all night. But alas, I must admit, this night is not about me. This night is about you. I'll leave you with these final words, and hopefully you will actually follow them. Should you ever find yourself at Nick's Burgers, yeah. I'm on the boulevard across from Kmart, and I'm sitting in a booth, feel free to stop by and say hello. Class of 2017, I congratulate you. I wish you the best. I love all of you. And I hope you find your path. Yes. Thank you. I would like to introduce our amazing jazz ensemble and our choir. Thank you again.
Yeah.
Are we getting our stuff?
Is it time? Yeah, soon.
It's time?
Almost.
To grab our diploma covers.
Class of 2017. This year's Halcyon is entitled Switching Gears, which is so fitting for your stage in life right now. You came to Citrus Valley as hardworking, dedicated students your freshman year and started in first gear. You switched into second gear your sophomore year and continued to embrace the tenets of class. Junior year was third gear, where you excelled in academics, activities, arts, and athletics. This year, you cruised into fourth gear and made good choices day in and day out, while thoroughly enjoying your senior year with new and longtime friends. Now, you're ready to switch into high gear and hit the open road. But before you do, I'd like to share with you some of your many accomplishments along the way. Please hold all applause until the end. In the area of academics, our school is recognized locally and nationally as an outstanding high school, and you have contributed greatly to the following accolades. This year, we were again named as one of America's best high schools by U.S. News and World Report, outranking all of the high schools in the Redlands Unified School District. We were named to the 2016 Honor Roll by the Campaign for Business and Educational Excellence.
This is all real? I didn't see it.
We were ranked by the Washington Post's America's Most Challenging High Schools. Out of nearly 40,000 high schools across this nation, we are ranked 1827. That puts Citrus Valley in the top 5% in the nation.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Your class has contributed greatly to this status. 29% of you have a total GPA of 3.5 or above, and 54 of you have a total GPA of 4.0 and above. The top five total GPA seniors are Emily Fu, 4.6, and the rest are so close I have to go a lot of tenths, decimals out. So here we go. Connor Rainville, 4.5977.
Oh.
Lucian Chow, 4.5952. Weslin Clark, 4.4977. And Jake 4.4706. 28.5% of you have a college GPA of 3.5 or above, and 56 of you have a college GPA of 4.0 and above. The top college GPA seniors are Connor Rainville, 4.79, Lucian Chow, 4.75, Emily Fu, 4.74, Weslin Clark, 4.60, and Jocelyn Tran, 4.59. There are 128 of you who have earned the high distinction of receiving a Golden State Seal Merit Diploma. 54 of you have become California Scholarship Federation Seal Bearers, and 18 of you have earned the Seal of Biliteracy. The following nine seniors have earned all three of these seals. Emily Fu, Lena Klabe, Liliana Madrigal, Timothy Mason, Giselle Sevilla, Cameron J. Smith, Jennifer Wynn, Carlos Soriano, and Jose Valle. This year, we offered 43 sections of AP classes. 472 students took at least one of the 1,116 AP tests given this year. Silviu Andronescu and Emily Fu each took 8 of these tests.
Oh my God.
117 of you received scholarships totaling $96,740 from the Redlands Community Scholarship Foundation. Our AVID program continues to grow, and this year we have 51 seniors. 100% of them have been accepted into a four-year college. Attendance and good grades go hand in hand. Sienna Beach, Brian Drews, Tuan Hong, and Samantha Pham had perfect attendance this school year.
Woo!
He's standing behind right there.
Cameron J. Smith had perfect attendance all 4 years of
Holy shit!
Class of 2017.
I would not be able to do that.
And had a year full of activities thanks to our amazing ASB. Our spirit weeks and rallies were fantastic. Thank you, Jade Ellis, Maddie Montano, and Blake Westerberg. Homecoming was at a great location in Riverside. We had fun at Summerfest and Lux. And we finished with a beautiful prom at the Majestic. Yep. At speech competition, Emily Fu and Lindsay Neighbors qualified for nationals and will travel to Alabama next week to compete.
Ooh.
The Robotics Club took home the gold and silver medals at the regional Skills USA competition. They went on to win first place and second place in the state and will travel to Kentucky on June 19th to represent the entire state of California at the national competition. The Friday Night Live Club sponsored our Red Ribbon Week activities to share the important message of the harmful effects of drugs, but instead choosing a healthier lifestyle. The Inspire Choir rocked the house with a winter and spring concert. Our counselors planned great activities during college week to get you excited about turning in your college applications, and we had a great career week that ended with the options fair. Our performing arts department is loaded with talent. They entertained us throughout the year with many wonderful performances, but how about that Beauty and the Beast?
Yeah.
My motto is, why drive to the Pantages when you can drive to Citrus Valley? The talent abounds at Citrus Valley, and the performing arts students never disappoint. Jazz Ensemble participated in their first jazz festival in 4 years and placed third. Pitt Orchestra was nominated for Best Musical for the second year in a row at the National Youth Theater Awards. Douglas Heron qualified for the Rotary Music Competition semifinals for Southern California. 100% of our instrumental music seniors are attending college next year. D'Angelo Parks and Ethan Miley auditioned and made the Southern California Honor Choir. The Advanced Mixed Choir, Lumière des Chansons, traveled to New York City in May, where they received a rating of silver in show choir and a rating of gold in chamber choir. They were invited to sing next year at Carnegie Hall from their average score of 93. D'Angelo Parks and Andrew Olson were given the Maestro Award for their outstanding solo in the choir set. Our choral singers collectively earned over $350,000 in scholarship money and or grants for their education next year. At the annual National Youth Theater Awards, the following seniors received top honors for their work in Beauty and the Beast. Supporting actor in a musical, Raphael Berglis and Andrew Olson as Cogsworth and Lumiere. Ensemble, Kate Weeks, Mark Vargas, Tyler DeVoe, Denali Linton, Amy Mira, Charisma Garcia, Elizabeth Hernandez, Andrew Olson, D'Angelo Parks, Raphael Berglis, Elizabeth Melgosa, Kareen Caroloon, Morgan Katinger, Lauren Ochoa, Morgan Taylor, Sarah Aranya, Samantha Pham, Brooke Ochoa, Essie Ubebo, and Rebecca Smith. Our athletic teams competed only their third year in the rugged Citrus Belt League. I'm so proud of the efforts and dedication of our coaches and student athletes as we compete in all sports in one of the oldest and arguably one of the most competitive leagues in the entire CIF Southern Section. Coach Paracci and the girls' track team made history with our first CBL championship when they beat UKIPA at UKIPA. And Claire Graves won her third straight CBL 3200 championship. Coach Espinoza and his baseball team also made history by winning our first CBL championship in baseball. Play with a perfect 11-win, 0-loss record.
Damn.
Talon Weck won swimming's first CBL championship in the 100 breaststroke with a team record of 59.57 seconds. Coach Hartley and our boys' soccer team made a run all the way to the CIF Southern Section Division III finals. I don't think anyone will ever forget the goal that wasn't a goal at that game versus El Dorado and the class displayed by every member of the team and the coaching staff. The following teams and individuals made it to playoffs. Girls and boys tennis, girls volleyball, boys and girls cross country, boys and girls soccer, boys water polo, baseball, and J.C. Smith and Chandler Tillman for girls golf. Our student athletes maintain an average 3.2 GPA in all sports. Our Ken Hubs Award nominees are Mark Rossi and Claire Graves. Claire was selected as the overall Ken Hubs Female Outstanding Athlete. The Sylvesville Area Athletic Directors Association Outstanding Athletes of the Year are Jordan Schaefer and Chandler Tillman. Cameron J. Smith was also honored by this group by being selected as a scholarship recipient.
Wait, what?
The Redlands Unified School District Fall, Winter, and Spring Outstanding Athletes are Claire Kavinsky, Cameron Smith, and Tristan Workman. Years, the Blackhawks are on the map in CBL, winning three CBL championships over the past 2 years. I know we will continue to work hard, put forth tremendous effort, and win many more CBL championships in the years to come. Congratulations to the class of 2017 for all of your amazing accomplishments. To the wonderful Blackhawks staff, thank you for guiding this outstanding group of students for the past 4 years. It is clear that none of us would be here tonight without your unending devotion to your career and to these students. Families and friends, thank you for your love and support and for sending us such outstanding individuals. Graduates, thank you for always being in the right gear and embracing the tenets of class. Thank you for the many extra activities you chose to do to make your high school experience so fun and full of memories. You have successfully navigated switching gears and have traveled this road well. We thank you for allowing us to be a part of it along the way, and we look forward to you switching into high gear and taking off. Congratulations. Woo! Board of Trustees, and Superintendent Rose. The members of this class present here tonight have fulfilled all of the requirements of the state of California and the local school board and are therefore eligible to receive their diplomas. It is indeed my pleasure and honor to present to you the Citrus Valley High School class of 2017.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Redlands Unified School District, it is my honor to receive this outstanding graduating class of 2017 from the Citrus Valley High School. Congratulations, graduates.
Okay.
Well, I thought it was
going to
continue.
I know. Pressure. Rooney!
We're going to get our diploma covers, but we have to come back to get our diplomas.
This is not that counts.
I know.
No.
That's so true.
It'd be a lot. Cards?
Now that I think about it, it'd be a lot longer.
Got it?
Oh my god. You ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Good job, Jack. Congrats.
Anna, you ready?
Yeah.
Joey?